man who is still recovering from the after party is Matt Moran, who won GQ's Food Force Award, and as a special treat, he joins us now. Please welcome Matt Moran. Congratulations.
Well, that's what it looks like.
Look,
but
fantastic.
I've got a confession to make. If you turn around, it's not mine.
Oh. I did wonder why it was a QG.
No.
You've got Vincent.
I've got Vincent Fantuzzo's.
Which is Asher Keddie's husband.
He swapped them. And I didn't realise until I got home last night.
That's awesome.
I thought I'm going to have to bring it. I looked and I sent him a text. He goes, well, I've already won Artist of the Year before, and you won Chef of the Year a couple of years ago, so we might as well have one of each. So,
yeah. Does that mean you have to take up painting now?
Yeah.
So I better do what the award says.
Say, food is art. So.
And I'll tell you what, your food is art. It's just fantastic. What are you up to at the moment?
Well, we've just launched the new Chiswick at the Art Gallery.
There you go, the art thing works.
There you go.
You say the art gallery, but which
specific the art gallery in New South Wales.
Yeah.
And we're renovating Opera Bar at the moment, so we reopen on the 10th of December. And we're building another one in Barangaroo.
And tell me, Matt, how do you manage your work-life balance?
Yeah!
good management and very, very good staff. You know, I said last night, and I sort of dedicated the award to my staff. You know, I think it's close to 600 now.
Mm. Wow.
And
oh my
I reckon
goodness.
There's a big chunk, probably about 40, that have been with me for, you know, 10 years or thereabouts.
That's a good sign.
Yeah.
Matt, talking about last
paying
night.
Too much money.
Let's take a quick look at the clip when you actually won.
I'm very humbled. It has been a very, very big year. Two new places this year, another TV series, a book. I'd really like to thank my partner of 24 years, Peter Sullivan. If anyone knows Peter, he's one of the driving forces. Now, I should just say that Peter is my partner in business, not in life.
Matt, being in business is so incredibly tough. You've spoken about staff. How integral is it to being a great business person to keep good staff?
Yeah, look, it's really important. And as I said, Peter and I have been partners now for 24 years. When we first started out, you know, I was the cook and he was the waiter. And I remember after the first 3 months of owning our own business, which was Paddington Inn, and we were trying to pay the bills, and we looked at the bank account and thought, geez, you know, we're doing really well, got heaps of money in the bank, but realised we hadn't paid anybody. So I suppose we decided then it was very important to surround ourselves with, you know, people that actually knew business better than what we did. And obviously over the years, you know, they've taught us a lot about business too.
And obviously having staff that just work for the love of it.
Yes.
Matt, can I just ask, have you got children?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, because often a woman in your situation would be asked, how do you juggle everything? As a dad, how do you do that?
Look, it's tough, especially when I'm filming, because I'm away a little bit. You know, Harry's just started high school this year, and Amelia's 9. A very understanding partner, wife, who sort of knows I'm mad and crazy, and, you know, I keep trying to do new things, and very supportive. Very independent, though, too. She has her own career, and, you know, she's very successful in that, too. So
once again, it's the team you've got around you.
Team around
Yeah.
So Matt, congratulations. True. We absolutely love you, and thanks so much for joining us today.
Nice to be on TV and not actually cooking for a change.
Oh no, didn't tell you. We've got a cooking segment coming up.
We've got a sausage sizzle out the back and about 60 people to feed.
There ain't no free brunch. Yeah.
Studio 10 continues right after this break. Don't go anywhere.